Hey Libra, welcome to Queen Airbend the Tarot. Today we are going to do your second week of October general love reading. Now keep in mind it's a general reading, which means it cannot possibly apply to every single person that's watching. But if you like a personal reading, all of the information will be left in the description box below. In case you are new to the channel, welcome, come on in. And in case you're returning, thank you for joining me again today. And I hope that you guys are doing well. Happy birthday, Libra. Leave in the comment section below what you guys have done or what you're going to do for your birthday. And I'm wishing you guys many, many beautiful years to come. Okay? Many blessings. So, Libra, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, and the visuals. When I was meditating over you guys' energy, the song that I got was Bleeding Love by Leona Lewis. Miss Leona Lewis happens to be an Aries, so you could be dealing with an Aries, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, and the visual. Or this could be involving someone that you met in Aries season, which is March, April time frame. Or it also could be talking about something that ended in Aries season. And I say this because I just heard one specific part of the song, and it's the very beginning of the hook. And she says, I don't care what they say, I'm in love with you. And that's chop. It just chopped. And that's all I heard. I literally heard that for a lot of y'all, you were dealing with somebody, you are or you were dealing with someone who is too concerned about what other people have to say, and they're always going to be miserable, or they always keep losing out on quality relationships because they are too concerned about how things look on the outside. And I know that sounds very juvenile, and it is. It's straight up, it is. But I know people personally like that. I know people personally who only care about the image, the name brand this, and live in this area and has to have the, you know, materialistic stuff. And they have to have a partner that looks like that because that looks good having this person on their arm, both men and women. And, but they're not happy wholeheartedly. You know what I'm saying? So that's the energy that I'm getting for somebody. And I'm going to tell you that we're going to jump into it now, okay? Because I want you to see the cards that help me realize, like, okay, this is very much on point. At the bottom of the deck, you have a Five of Wands, conflicts, arguments, disagreements, too many people creating some type of conflictual energy here. Like, it's causing this person to think conflictually, act conflictually, because these are actions. They're acting against each other. Back of the deck, you have the Three of Cups. There's a lot of people here. A lot of goddamn people. A lot of people, like, they can have two people that's very close to them that you see how these two cups are pointed to one. It's like they get in this person's head, and then this person gets in their feelings based off of the stuff that, you know, these people say to them. Somebody can have a water sign, Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio, or a fire sign, Leo, Sag, Aries, family member, friend, somebody like that, that is like, that's their confident, that's their ace, boom, coon, okay? And they trust their discernment, or they trust what they say, and it's like, you know, there's a lot of miserable people, you know what I'm saying? A lot of negative Nancys and stagnant Steves, and they're not very happy in their life, so they deflect, and they rub their energy off on people. And that's what I'm getting there. But here's the thing. I feel like with you, they found happiness. And it's shaking up their whole foundation. It's changing how they see stuff. It's a new day with you. When the sun comes up, it is a brand new day. Something brand new is coming into your life. Back of the deck here, you have the Page of Wands. So again, some of you guys definitely could be dealing with fire signs, specifically a Leo. Doesn't have to be. Leona Lewis, again, is an Aries, so it could be an Aries also, Aries Leo. But more than anything, you see how he's going. As I move this from behind the deck, he's going towards the sun. I feel like this person don't give a fuck. Like she said at the beginning of the song, I don't care what they say. I'm in love with you. Like, this person is realizing that they have growth with you. You see how he's looking at the bud and leaves? I'm also getting that somebody may have told this person, like, okay, this person is a hit it and quit it or something like that, because he's also looking at the tip of that wand, and wands typically are very sexual and phallic energy also, you know what I mean? But I feel like somebody's realizing, like, it's more than a hit it and quit it or a situationship type of situation, because again, it's blossoming, it's budding leaves, which means there could be more to it. I'm also getting, like, somebody has a bad reputation, whether it's true or not. You know how people get to gossip, and I don't give a damn how old you are. People talk too much and say a lot of shit, okay? I'm 40, and I've been in social circles where people are still talking about how this friend slept with that same person, and they were talking in circles, and I'm just like, y'all messy. You know, I've heard that even at my big age. So you could have, if there's people that you know in the same social circle, somebody could be gossiping and talking about how someone is promiscuous or they've slept with this person also, and so somebody may have said, well, I can't be serious with this person because my friend slept with this person, like, whatever, whatever. But they're realizing, like, they don't give no fuck because they got feelings. Like, this is, somebody makes you happy or you make somebody happy. Somebody may also end up getting pregnant, so be mindful about that as well if that's not the route you're trying to go. So let's go ahead and go through the deck until we get your major arcana, which happens to be the Justice card. We'll get the card that comes before and the card that comes after, and then we'll get clarifiers for those cards. Ten of Swords. Yeah, people talk about shit behind somebody's back, possibly yours, because you are Swords, okay? We are in October. You got 10, Ten of Swords. Some of you guys could find out that people have been talking shit. Oh, yeah. Again, remember I said the part of song I just kept hearing and it stopped. I don't care what they say. Swords, communication, and mental. You say stuff with the Swords. I don't care what they say. I'm in love with you. So somebody's talking shit behind somebody's back. And I'm talking about big shit because there's a lot of Swords here, right? It's like always saying some negative stuff. And I feel like this is definitely playing out in October. Or it's going to play out before October, you know, before Libra in October wraps up. I feel like somebody's being spoken very ill of. And I don't think that's going to matter to you or this person. Because even around here, look at all this dull energy here, but you got these red flowers blossoming like growth. Again, it's like somebody sees growth with you or you see growth with someone. Regardless of what other people say, there's hills here, mountains. Mountains and hills talk about hurdles and challenges that you have to get over. I feel like you guys, like, what you once thought was a challenge or a hurdle, it no longer matters. I really get that. Somebody's thinking about moving forward. And again, 81's fast-moving communication coming out of blue unexpectedly. I'm telling you, somebody is talking shit. Somebody has some input and wants to, you know, say something about a love interest. But see, I feel like for a lot of y'all, you see something in them that, you know, you don't see them the way that other people are projecting them. Now, this doesn't have to be just social circles. This could be like family. Okay, you see how this card on slide? I see we're going to look at that. But it could also be family. I'm going to tell you initially, before I even start the camera, I got something with cultural. Like, family doesn't support it because it's a cultural situation. And also possibly the same-sex situation. Like, family doesn't support. I'm getting that also. Yeah, but it's like, I don't give a fuck. I'm going off. I'm jumping off the deep end. Absolutely. Knights are either going into battle, coming out of battle, going on some type of journey or adventure. And like I said, this is going to come out in Libra season. I also feel as though for you all, because you guys are Swords, you're Libra, I feel like for a lot of y'all, you may defend this person. Or you defended this person before you jumped off the ledge without knowing all the details about this individual. We could be talking about someone whose first, middle, last initial is AEV. K, T, W, or S, okay? Bottom of the deck, you got two knights here, okay? So I feel like, yeah, could be dealing with Taurus, Queen of Pentacles, Knight of Pentacles. I feel like for a lot of you all, family and friends may be telling you to slow down because this is the slowest moving knight in the whole entire deck of tarot. They could be telling you to slow down. Don't jump into it too quick. Don't just offer everything. Put all your eggs in one basket because this is a major, you know, this is solid. This is stable. Pentacles have worth. They have value. So they're like, don't jump into that too quickly. Okay. And I also feel like somebody's trying to downplay somebody's value. Like I said, I'm getting some messy-ass gossip stuff here. Okay. So again, we want your major arcana, which is the Justice card, the card that comes before and the card that comes after for Libra, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus individuals. I feel like there's a hater also who doesn't want you to be with someone, but I feel like it's a very... they have some type of motive behind that. So right in front of you, you have, look what I say, it's too many people. You started off with the Five of Wands, now you have the Five of Swords. Then you had Three of Cups up under that, now you got the, again, the Five of Swords, you got one, two, three people. Hearing straight out of a horse's mouth, okay? It definitely could be a fire sign because the flames isn't coming out of a horse's mouth, but it looks like it is. So it could be a fire sign, and I did say Leona Lewis is an Aries, and we also have the Sun card, Leo. So it could be a fire sign saying something. But I don't feel like they're speaking positively of you or this person. Because this is conflict, you know. They want this person to be defeated. These people are defeated here. Huh. Then there's your energy. And then behind that you have Three of Swords. Keep bleeding. She's talking, you know. She's talking about bleeding love. That's the heart. That's exactly what Three of Swords is. So... some of you guys could be indifferent, like you're not sure what to do, okay? Because you see how the ship, relationship is being struck by lightning. Some of you guys are uncertain about what to do, whether you should trust what people say or move on to what makes you happy. Or that's how someone that you're dealing with has, that's the questions they have about you. Some of you guys definitely are dealing with a earth sign, okay? Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. or we just got out of Virgo season. This could have been something that you dealt with in Virgo season possibly 3 weeks ago. Doesn't have to be, but I'm just putting that out there. Bottom of the deck, you have the Chariot. Chariot is your divine vehicle. It's going to move you forward. Reverse is a standstill, or it's not. This could be like going in reverse. I don't feel like that's the case. I feel like in this situation, somebody's planning to move forward with you, regardless of what other people have to say. People, you know, somebody's planning on moving forward with you, or you're planning on moving forward with a situation or with a connection. Now, if you are completely single, I'm going to tell you what I'm getting is like, people in your life was causing havoc, or somebody was too busy listening to what other people had to say, and that caused endings in again, very valuable relationships. Let's go ahead and part and see what we got here. The Nine of Cups. This is getting everything that you want and some, having wish fulfillment, feeling content, but I always say behind that curtain, we don't know what's behind that curtain, what's behind the scenes. So somebody could be saying, you know, saying something to reveal, it's like you're happy and you're content with this person, or this person's happy and content with you. And then people are like, you don't know everything about this person, or do you really know everything about this person? It's like making you question someone, a love interest. Let's get a clarifier for the Five of Swords, as well as Three of Swords. I almost said Three of Cups. Somebody could be drinking and saying too much, just talking too damn much, and just loud and wrong, to be quite honest with you. Bottom of the deck, look, again, see? Drama. So you got the Five of Swords again. You got those two people. It could be two people for sure, like mutual friends talking crap about somebody. There could be like you guys out having drinks, dinner, whatever, and then something just comes out. It's like they're saying negative things about this person in hopes to persuade you to not move forward with a connection with them, or somebody saying something about you. But again, in reverse, I feel like whatever they're saying, it's like you don't care. Just like the lyrics of the song, I don't care what they say. I'm in love with you. That's somebody has already caught feelings for someone. Five of Swords, universal energies of light, love, and divine protection. You need to clarify for the Five of Swords. Ooh, that flew out. You have the Three of Wands. You see a positive future with this person, or this person see a positive future for you with you. They see like things go to the next level, regardless of what other people have to say. Because again, this always makes me think straight out of the horse's mouth. I'm going to say again, the flames like near the horse's mouth, it could definitely be a fire sign, or it's a fire sign telling you something negative, or your person something negative, or a fire sign is being spoken very ill of, you know. Bottom of the deck, yeah. What I say? You got Leo again. You got Two of Cups, Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio, but I'm going to say again, I feel like people want you to be in this energy, but this is what you'd rather be in. You'd rather be in connection with some with this person. This is soulmates. This is a love union. This is union. Okay, there's an equal exchange. I feel like for a lot of you all, this person, again, this could either be you that's like this, listening to people too much, or you were in the past, or this could be someone that you're dealing with. I feel like in the past, they were always listening to what other people had to say, but it's like, fuck what they gotta say, because it's just you and me in this connection, and we just vibe. Like the energy between us is equal, it's mutual, and we just work well together. We mesh well together, so we don't give a damn about what nobody else gotta say. Not anymore, because somebody did care at one point in this situation. Let's get a clarifier for the Three of Swords, universal energies of light, love, and divine. Okay. And you see that one flipped up, so I'm gonna take it. It didn't flip out, but it pop, pop, pop. And I know I'm gonna take it. You know why? Because you got three. Okay, so you got the Three of Cups, upright, there's unions, rejoicing, coming together. It's in reverse. Now, again, I know it was meant for me to take that, even though it flipped back down, but I've seen it. We seen how that popped up. You got three, three, three. Okay, I knew it was meant for me to take that. You guys may see synchronicities in 333. I always use this example, like you be driving behind somebody's car, their license plate number could be PRJ333. You can buy something at a store and the total is 333. You may even, and I don't tell people to do this, disclaimer, I'm not telling you to gamble, but you may want to go play the pick three and play 333. Some of you guys, you're going to win some money. But I also feel like there could be people, there's just a social circle, a group of people who don't want to see you happy. Somebody, I told you, has a motive. Because you can see their faces, but you can't see hers. and this is someone that you connect with, or your person connects with, and they're always, they trust this person's discernment, they trust what this person has to say, they respect this person, but there's a motive, because we can't see their face, which means we can't even see what their true intentions are. It could be some shady shit. They're single and alone, so they want you to be single and alone, or your person be single and alone, or they don't want this person to be in a relationship because they're scared that they won't be able to kick with them anymore, or the connection will fail, or whatever. It's something with this 333 here. Someone also could have a birthday that has a 3 in it. The 3rd, 13th, 23rd, 30th, 31st. Also, it could have been 3 months ago since you spoke to this person that we're talking about right now. You would know how that applies. Yeah, it's like, don't listen to what these people have to say, because they don't want you to be happy. Or this specific person, because there's a specific person that does not want you to be happy. I'm noticing that both of these people have, with their backs facing us, have the red on, and that makes me think about, if you're new to the channel, I always say when I see characters with red on, it always makes me think about Aries. It always does. And I did say Leona Lewis, who sings that song, is an Aries. So it could be involving an Aries person. Okay? Or somebody, or something that happened in Aries season, March, April time frame. You got 3 here, so that's March. So something significant can associate with March. Doesn't have to. Just putting out all the variables out there. Okay? So, Libra, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, and the visuals. As always, I'm going to ask that you continue to like, share, subscribe. Click that notification button. Until next time, take care and be well, and happy birthday. Bye.